Welcome back to another reaction video brought to you by leveldowngames.com. My name's Brian, and today we'll be taking a look at and reacting to Nacon Connect for 2021. Let's go ahead and check this out.
Game consoles have come out. The engineers designing our peripherals and the studios developing our games are as passionate and creative as ever. At a time when entertainment has become such an important part of our lives. Whether you enjoy role-playing games, racing, sports, deck builders...
Got our boy Gollum up here. We should be getting an update on the Lord of the Rings Gollum during this, so we'll see.
A keyboard and a mouse, an arcade stick, a headset, at home in public transportation, with friends or by yourself. We give it our all to meet your every need, and in order to celebrate these truly out of the ordinary times, we have a few extraordinary surprises in store for you.
I can't imagine there'll be anything too huge here, but still, you never know. You never know.
When did life become so cheap? Have we always been so fragile? I have lived many lifetimes. I've watched empires rise and fall. I've played politics. I've fallen in love and stood by as love died. And what do I have to show for it? Nothing. I am eternal. You are not. But rest assured, the end I gift you is
Vampire the Masquerade
than having to exist for yet another damn night.
Okay, yeah. This was previously announced. It could be good. It looks good. Get rid of that ad. February 2022. At least we got a month. Not bad.
Hi, I'm Harold Riegler, producer at Didelic Entertainment, and today I'm happy to reveal some exciting details about our upcoming game.
Oh, here we go! Lord of the Rings Gollum! Right at the start! Not bad. Man, I'm pumped for this game. I hope it's good.
Gollum has always fascinated us. While being completely essential to the story written by J.R.R. Tolkien, Gollum's long chase for his precious ring has never been told in detail. Yet his incredible journey from Mordor through Mirkwood to the mines of Moria
takes
players to places they haven't seen like this before.
This could be really, really cool. I can't wait. I hope it's good.
The fate of all of Middle-earth. Gollum has pretty much.
I don't like that
everywhere.
We're not seeing much here He's besides artwork and stuff, though. That's a little.
By looking at events from his angle,
I mean, there are some things, right? There's some gameplay there.
Through the eyes and twisted mind of one of the most iconic characters of all time. All of that in our very own artistic style. From his time in the slave pits of the Dark Tower to his stay with the elves of Mirkwood, Gollum
That's gorgeous.
Will creep, sneak, and trick his way past faithful, detailed environments, some of which have never been seen before in such detail. The Lord of the Rings Gollum is a cinematic stealth action adventure. It mixes stealth and parkour gameplay and really leverages Didelic's expertise in crafting engaging stories. Gollum is no traditional hero. He's learned not to take any sides other than his own, and some of the most powerful beings in Middle-earth want him either captive or dead. In the game, you will meet some iconic characters, but also interesting personalities less known to players, but nonetheless essential to the events unfolding. We've been highly faithful to the descriptions in the books, depicting, for instance, the Moth of Sauron, the Lieutenant of Barad-dûr, who is constantly scheming on behalf of his Dark Lord. In the game, we will see his face for the first time, but also Thranduil, King of the Elves of Mirkwood, father
That's
of
a
Legolas,
fucking cool character model right there.
Least,
Gandalf looks good too.
We're all super excited to be working on this amazing project, and we can't wait to show you more. Stay tuned on social media at Gollum Game.
Oh man, why didn't we see more gameplay though? I wonder how far. Fall 2022. Okay, I was gonna say, I wonder how far out this actually is. Still about a year and a half away, with potential delays in store, so. Oh well, hopefully it's good.
Thank you.
This just came out not that long ago, right? Like, somewhat recently. That fucking drum is sick. Or enemy that's on the drums. Oh man, these ads just keep popping up. Unfortunate. Okay. What the fuck was that? Ad infinitum. 2023. Okay. Alright.
What's up, it's swansong, and I'm here to talk to you guys about Sessions Game. This game, for me, is the best skateboarding game out there. The way it looks, the way it plays, just overall, what these developers have done with this game is amazing. So hopefully you guys all get to check it out, and I want to thank them for letting me be involved as a character. And just, you guys got to check it out. It's the best game ever. So check out the new trailer.
I've had this game since, like, the beginning, early days of Early Access. And I haven't played it in quite some time. I remember struggling with the controls. So I'm wondering how it plays now. Trailer makes it look great, though. Might have to reinstall it and give it a go.
Hello, I'm Jahan Russo, president of Spiders. Many of you
Oh, steelrising. Cool, yeah.
Steelrising.
Spiders makes me, you know, they're going to be hit or miss, right? But all the ads, come on, the ads.
Call your witness, bro.
Skip it. And let's get rid of the annotations as well. So the bad thing about not doing it, like, exactly live is that you've got to put up with the ads. Spiders was bound by flame. And that was okay. Not really. They did Greedfall, which was pretty good. This looks okay. Not really. I don't know. I don't know about this one. Like, the aesthetic and the setting is badass, but June of next year? The gameplay kind of looked like so bland there. I mean, oh man. We'll have to see as that one gets closer. Because right now, that's a big I don't know. Yeah. Rugby? Okay. I don't pay attention enough to, like, the sports games outside of the majors, like FIFA, Madden, well, I guess EA Sports technically stuff, and then 2K stuff. Is there always a rugby game every year? I don't know that there is.
It's Bob from the Bloody Beetroots, and today I'm really excited to talk to you about Rims Racing. I have been playing video
games. Damn, what
since
if I started wearing
kid,
a
and my first
face shield like that? That's actually pretty fucking cool.
Motorbike. So, talking about Bloody Beetroots, motorcycle, and video games is like speaking the same language on different disciplines. Being able to collaborate and create a soundtrack with RaceWord and Nacon for Rims Racing is something really cool for me. Rims is all about the thrill of riding a sport bike at insane speeds. So I've created a soundtrack to match that adrenaline rush. You might already know some of the tracks, but there's a lot of exclusive music that can only be discovered in Rims.
That's pretty cool.
Guess what? Pre-orders start tonight, but that's not the only surprise. Check this out.
Not interested, Humble Bundle. I already subscribed, so. Could be good, right? I mean, shit. Who knows? Not bad. Not bad at all. Oh. Road Lords.
They're all here. The greatest disciples of evil.
I like the art style.
What a pleasure it is to see you in action once again.
Dr. Frankenstein, okay. Find the lost
another
artifacts.
Night, another conquest. By dawn, these lands will be mine.
So it's like a turn base then.
You shall not leave until all the mortals in this region have bowed down before me.
Wow, that's kind of, this is kind of cool. I'm digging this.
The dice were loaded from the start. Welcome to hell.
PC release coming soon. Damn, that looks cool.
Hey there, loser. really thought that Blood Bowl was just about spilling blood and wrenching balls? You're in the big leagues now. That's why you need a sponsor.
Approved by the best Nurgle team.
I think Frank likes these games. I like the dwarves. I mean, it just doesn't look that appealing to me, but February of next year? Okay.
Hello, my name is Johan Druder. I'm lead cinematic artist at Cyanide and also co-wrote the Blood Bowl 3 campaign. Blood Bowl is a turn-based tactical game inspired by American football, set in the Warhammer fantasy world. The game is spectacular, brutal, chock-full of humor and satire. The important thing about Blood Bowl 3 is we have adapted the new edition of the board game. Quite a few of the new game mechanics are coming straight from the board game.
That's actually kind of neat, though.
Most pitches have rules which can change the outcome of a match. Some pitches can even transform themselves during the match if specific requirements are met. For instance, on the Dark Elf pitch, if you score a touchdown in the first half, a Kraken appears, and the match obviously becomes much tougher. As you could see in the trailer, the campaign is built around the theme of sponsors. During the campaign, you will have to face a bunch of star players, who are the public faces of these sponsors. They are both very strong and very charismatic. Rejoice, Blood Bowl aficionados, Varag Gulchua is back. He's an Orc star player, and a brutal and vicious one at that. In the campaign, he created a gym chain with the Orcidus brand, whose methods are rather unconventional. We decided to base the campaign on fake sponsors and star players for gameplay-related reasons. We wanted players to create their own teams, from any race. This narrative choice gave us lots of room for humor and satire, both quintessential aspects of the Blood Bowl license. Each sponsor has their own parody ad spot. Of course, Jim and Bob are back to commentate matches, and during the campaign, they'll be paired up with a few guests who pitch in for the occasion. It was a great pleasure to show you our work. I can't wait for you guys to check out Blood Bowl 3. Hello everyone, I'm Sebastian Loeb. I'm here today to tell you about the new WRC 10 game. As you might know, the WRC is 50 years old this year. That's why Nacon and KT Racing wanted to celebrate that birthday by offering you a bit of a special edition. The game's physics have improved drastically. I was lucky enough to try out the game, and whether on tarmac or gravel, the sensations are very realistic, and they're different from what we could have in the past. The game feels really good. It was a cool experience. Apart from that, you will find out about everything that's happened during those 50 years of WRC. As for me, the game includes my first victory at Rally Deutschland, my first victory on ice at Rally Sweden, and my last victory in Catalonia. All of these memories are quite amazing, but there are others. A lot of drivers wrote their names in the history of the WRC during all these years. All of that will be featured in the game.
That's kind of cool.
I hope you'll enjoy it.
Ah, there's an ad coming up
for the game's release.
WRC games are generally pretty well received, right?
I don't know about you, but I love trying out new experiences. So follow me because I'll show you that anything is possible. Last week, I had the chance to show what I can do as a chef. Every element of a dish is important, and it's what makes every creation so unique. The customers understand this, and
this might be a game for Jessica right here.
Every night. Fortunately, I am fully prepared, and the team is on top of it. Yesterday, I was in Thailand to open my hotel. My team and I needed to ensure
everything was perfect.
We were fully booked almost immediately, and with revenue up, I was able to build a larger pool and redecorate. The guests were so happy.
Yeah, she's going to like this one.
I'm awarded 5 stars. Today, I decided to travel solo. I'm a train enthusiast and love to take passengers and goods to their destination. I could explore Europe and its stations and even drive a famous Orient Express train. And tomorrow, I'm still deciding whether to become a surgeon or maybe an architect.
Life! Oh, it's coming to Switch! It's got like a bunch of different simulators all in one. That's kind of fucking cool. Oh, look at these controllers.
Hello, my name is Yannick Allard. It's a great pleasure to be a part of Nacon Connect. As we just saw with Nacon and Rick,
gotta keep getting rid of the ads.
Was particularly eventful when it comes to our peripherals.
I'm sure you guys do the same thing when they're in my videos. Most of the time, not even my choice. Xbox, the Pro Compact controller. Most of my videos have copyright claims on them, just not copyright strikes.
This customizable controller for consoles and PCs is the first of its kind to include the Dolby Atmos technology for your headset. We've also developed 2 official controllers dedicated to cloud gaming on smartphones, the MGX series, specifically designed for you to enjoy Xbox Game Pass Ultimate wherever you are. The MGX and the MGX Pro are compatible with every smartphone on the market and will be available very shortly. The Revolution X will be out soon. It's a premium, fully customizable controller built for competitive Xbox players. Check out this trailer.
Jessica probably liked the shape of that controller. We just had to search for one for her for the for PC and Switch for something better. We found one, but that's not a bad shape.
The Revolution X is the result of our combined expertise in design, customization, and technology. We can't wait to tell you more about it. Nacon Connect is the perfect opportunity to reveal some of our upcoming accessories, which involve
so
another
Nacon
of your favorite game consoles. I'm talking about the PlayStation 5, of course. By the end of the year, 2 new rig headsets officially licensed for PlayStation 5 will be available. The Rig 400 HS and the Rig 500 Pro HS. For streamers, Rig also developed an optimized streaming microphone for the PlayStation 5, the Rig 200 HS streaming mic. From Nacon, we will soon launch a brand new version of our arcade stick, the Daija, officially licensed for PlayStation 5. Thanks to the invaluable support of Kayane, with whom we already worked with on the PS4 version, the Daija arcade stick will be back improved and enhanced, offering an experience worthy of the next generation. Whether for console or PC, many more projects are planned for the months to come. For you, with you, we'll keep developing and improving your controllers, your headsets, your keyboards, so you can enjoy the best possible gaming experience. Enjoy the rest of Nacon Connect.
Hello, My name is Andres Borges.
I didn't realize they made so many peripherals. I knew they made peripherals. I just didn't know they made so many.
And game directors at Ace Team. And we're very excited to show everyone the new game we've been working on.
Okay, I'm already into this. I love the art style. Digging the music. It's so different. Sort of reminds me of Sable a little bit, right? That's coming out soon, but... way more vibrant. I want to play this just for the art style, but the game looks fun too. Curious exactly what type of game it actually is.
Time and chance happen to us all.
Seen a couple different elements there.
Is to the strong.
That's a cool looking enemy or whatever it is. Clash. Artifacts of Chaos, June of next year. Okay. Nice, coming to next gen consoles too. That's exciting. Forgot they were the studio doing Test Drive. A friend of mine and I, back when I was like, I don't know, 12, 13, 14 years old, during the PS1 N64 era. So think like 98 through 2000 maybe. We used to love playing the Test Drive games on PlayStation and N64. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm very interested to check this new one out. What is it, Unlimited? Test Drive Unlimited or something like that? I don't remember exactly what it's called. We'll find out here soon. Trailer. Good song choice, too. Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown. September 22nd, 2022. Man.
Bonjour. Hello, I'm Alain Janu, creative director at KT Racing.
That looks kind of good.
And I'm Amaury Beris, game and art director.
At KT Racing, we specialize in developing motor racing games. That means we use our own game engine and that we develop our own technology. We always improve it to make it as realistic as possible, especially when it comes to simulation and motor racing, but also for creating environments. We always want to respect the places we render, so we reproduce environments on a one-to-one scale. Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown is first and foremost a Test Drive Unlimited game. It's a MMO, which means a lot of players
okay.
get to play together.
It's an sort of like Forza Horizon, then.
You can go off-road.
Dope.
All of the above is essential to the Test Drive Unlimited license,
okay.
and we've obviously included that in Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown. The next stop for Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown is Hong Kong. When we think of Hong Kong, we think of a big city, an urban jungle filled with skyscrapers, luxury cars, etc. But behind all that are vast natural landscapes, forests, mountains, marshes, beaches, many environments that fit a car racing game very well. Beside the Solar Crown tournament, two clans face each other. We can tell you their names, the Streets and the Sharps. They both share the same love for luxury cars and competition, but each of them has their own view of the world and is ready to fight for it, both as an individual, because players will join a clan and will try to climb up the ladder within his clan, and as a group, a family trying to overthrow the other clan. The player will both belong to and evolve within their clan.
We're glad to have shared all this information with
this
you.
This seems really cool. Drive Unlimited, I think I'm going to have to pick this up next year. This looks good.
Fall 2022. And until then,
sucks that it's, again, like a year and 3 months away, right? But
information.
Looks good. Looks really good.
Top story. Old Detroit. Crime has escalated to new heights. Authorities are overwhelmed. OCP insists the situation is under control. But the question remains, who or what will send these crooks on the run and restore peace to all citizens once and for all?
RoboCop! Okay! RoboCop Rogue City. May 23, not even really any gameplay footage or anything. Fuck! Is that it? I think that might be it, guys. Yeah. Yeah, this is the closeout screen according to the video, so let's go ahead and go back to our large cam to close this one out. Thank you so much for being a part of this reaction video made possible, of course, by leveldowngames.com. Are you excited about anything highlighted during the showcase? Let us know down in that comment section below. Also, if you like us, be sure to help support us. Hit that subscribe button to keep seeing us. And if you like this particular video, hitting that like button down below is the best way to let us know. Be sure to catch brand new episodes of the Love It On Games podcast every Tuesday on all major podcast platforms. And until next time, stay safe out there.